issues, the mic and connectivity. Okay. Very good morning, everyone. Welcome back to today's lecture. In the concepts of, we have understood in the last lecture, we have seen the concepts of merchant banking. Now, understanding the concepts of merchant banking with respect to the economic perspective, what was the role of a particular merchant banker? How does the different merchant bankers play a different role? And in terms of the capital market, equity market, debt market, debenture market, bond market, stock market, and so on. Further, now the another function or the identification of the merchant banker is with respect to the loan syndication. Now, whenever we are dealing with the respect of the functions of the merchant banker, in terms of the functions, it were having around 10 to 15 functions which a merchant banker has to follow. Furthermore, we have also seen and understood about what are the various different codes of conduct wherein a merchant banker has to follow all these compliances, all these particular norms, and how he makes these compliances with the respective trading authorities, government authorities, with respect to the state government, central government, Reserve Bank of India, and majorly SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. Under the registration, a particular merchant banker has to compulsory or mandatorily get himself registered with the Securities and Exchange Board of India, and accordingly, he has to file the different documents or the formats or the various compliances with respect to the documents also has to make time to time. Further, now starting with the concept, now we have also seen with the size of issue. So if the size of issue is less than 50 crore, then maximum number of merchant bankers that can be appointed is 2. If the size of issue, that is if you are going for an IPO, that is initial public offering, and you have to maintain the proper books of accounts of records, and a minimum period of 5 years duration is there. Now, the publishing of the financial papers or the financial documents. So at every year, minimum of at least 5 years of documents has to be submitted with the SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. And then only you can get the permission to enter into the IPO or the new issue market. So proper submission of books of accounts, that is with respect to the trading account, profit and loss account, balance sheet, and so on, has to be submitted. A proper authorized or acknowledgement has to be taken with the SEBI, and then only you can appoint a respective merchant banker. Now, for the appointment of merchant banker, the appointment of merchant banker specifically depends upon what is your share capital or the issue size. That is, aap market mein kitna paisa raise karne ke liye ja rahe ho. Now, your amount of raising can be below 10 crore, 50 crore, 100 crores, 200 crore, 500 crore, and so on. So, depending on the size of your issue. Now, this particular size of issue specifically deals with or the concerns with the amount in the specific consideration. Now, the size of issue, if it is less than 50 crore, then you can appoint maximum number of 2 merchant bankers. If the size of issue is between 50 crore to 100 crore, then 3 merchant bankers can be appointed. From 100 crore to 200 crore, it is 4 merchant bankers. From 200 to 400, it is 5. And more than 400 crore, it is 5 or more merchant bankers can be appointed. But at every point of time, you have to take the prior approval of the SEBI authority. Now, with respect to the second perspective, we are looking with the another as a function or the feature of merchant banker is the consideration of loan syndication. So, say loan syndication is an arrangement where a group of bankers participate for a single loan. Now, in the earlier slide, what you have seen, now whenever a particular company is raising a certain sum of money, so for raising this particular amount of money, it is not possible for an individual company to raise this certain sum of money. For example, take a situation wherein Tata or Reliance Infrastructure Limited, so that is RIL. Now, Reliance Infrastructure, a certain project has been given for them, and for completion of this particular project, the capital amount or the amount of requirement is 100 crore or 1000 crore. Now, whenever this particular amount of 1000 crore has been required, what happened? The individual company, that is individual Reliance Industries as a particular single firm, he cannot raise or they cannot form a certain form of capital wherein this particular amount can be raised by a single firm. So what the Reliance Industries will do, they will contribute or they will provide the quotations or they will provide the bid to different companies. They will invite to different companies to participate into this concern, and accordingly, the amount will be raised from different vendors. So whenever the particular amount will be floated, it can be floated to IPO, it can be floated to the stock market, it can be floated to the primary or the secondary market, or they can approach the different bankers also. Now, when the different organizations or different corporations or different individuals, they come together and they start to contribute this particular sum of money, this particular process of contributing or raising a certain sum or raising a particular fund of money is called as a loan syndication. Now, specifically, the amount of rupees 1,000 crore that has to be raised, it is specifically called as a loan, wherein whenever a particular different organizations, different vendors, different people, whenever they will be giving a certain sum of money to Reliance Industries, Reliance Industries in return has to repay or has to they have to repay or either give back those particular sum of money within a specific time of duration. So, जैसा आप नॉर्मल टर्म्स में एक पर्टिकुलर बैंक से आप लोन लेते हो वैसे आपको एक पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन को भी वो पर्टिकुलर लोन रिफंड करना है. सो नाउ कंटिन्यूइंग दिस एग्जांपल, फॉर एग्जांपल रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज लिमिटेड फ्रॉम द देयर सेल्फ दैट इज द ओन सेल्फ कैपिटल दे हैव रेज्ड 100 करोर. From the State Bank of India, the amount was raised as 150 crore. From the HDFC, the amount raised was 350 crore. From the personal individual, that is Vijay Mallya, amount of rupees 100 crore was been raised. From a particular state government, that is State of Maharashtra, they have given 100 crore. And another individual participant, that is Savitri Jindal. Savitri Jindal came forward and she has provided another 300 crore. So in this way, what happened? The combination of all, that is 100 plus 150 plus 350 plus 100 plus 100 plus 300, and in all this particular total, the amount was been raised as 1,000 crore, and then the project has been started and the financing was been done. So in this way, what happened? The loan syndication is a particular process wherein the different organizations, different participants, a different group of banks or different individuals come forward and they contribute a certain sum of money to different individuals or to different participants, and accordingly, the amount of fund is been raised. Now, coming with the perspectives of what is the benefits or what are the various advantages of loan syndication. First thing is that it is having a uniform approach for raising a certain sum of money or raising a certain amount of capital, whatever is been required. So, uniform approach that wherein, for example, RIL, SBI, HDFC, Vijay Mallya, State of Maharashtra, and Savitri Jindal. Everyone is contributing for a single purpose or a single motive, that is a uniform approach of contributing a certain sum of money to a single project, and that particular project is of 1,000 crore costing. Qualitative appraisal. Now, always at every point of time, you can have a qualitative approach. Now, you must have heard a certain concept called as a capital budgeting. Now, in terms of in capital budgeting, what we have a certain terminology, that is, now this particular terminology is the consideration of payback period or the net present value. Now, whenever we are understanding the concept of payback period, what everyone is expecting for, ki maine jo paisa diya tha, ki for example, if State Bank of India is saying that 150 crore I have given, HDFC is saying that 350 crore I have given within a specific time duration. Now, this particular specific time duration, can be either 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, or 10 years. So, within this specific time duration, what return I am expecting? So this particular, now you have to identify the rate of return also. So the rate of return, that is the rate of interest, can be either 1%, 2%, 5%, 6%, or whatever it may be. So depending on this particular, identify in qualitative basis and in quantitative basis, what we are getting in return as a certain perspective. That is, whenever this particular project will be completed. Now, what is this particular project? For example, this particular project is of building of a particular dam on Chenab River. Now, Chenab River is situated in Jammu and Kashmir, and we have to build a particular dam, and this particular dam will be benefiting from water resources to the different states or the different cities of this particular Jammu and Kashmir. So whenever this particular amount will be raised or whenever this particular amount will be incorporated or utilized for construction of a particular dam, the benefit that will be arising, it will be after 10 years. So your payback period or your net present value has to be calculated for a certain duration at the rate of interest that you have decided, whether it is 1%, 2%, 5%, 6%, 3%, whatever it may be. So quantitative terms. Quantitative terms is specifically related with the payback period and NPV. And qualitative appraisal is in respect of completion of project. That is, if the particular desired amount of duration. Now, if the duration of particular project is, for example, 10 years, and if the project gets extended, that is, it becomes 12 years to complete this particular project, then your amount of investment differs, your amount of returns also differs, and accordingly, the project may run into losses also. So in this way, we have to identify both the perspective, that is, what is the qualitative benefit to the company, that is a merchant banker, and what is the quantitative benefit to the company, that is a merchant banker, or the society at large. Third perspective is the risk disbursement. Now, what is the concept of risk disbursement? Now, in this case, at every stage or every point of time, there is an involvement of risk. That is, there may be a high risk, medium risk, or low risk. Now, who is the particular authority? There are various credit rating agencies. There are various different bankers who identify and who state what is the involvement of risk into this particular project. So identification of risk into a particular project has also to be identified, and accordingly we have to see that in what duration the risk can be dispersed. Now, dispersion of risk. Now, dispersion of risk, for example, Reliance Industries Limited. Now, whenever a particular amount has to be returned or pay back to the investors, Reliance Industries, it can perform well. State Bank of India will also perform well. HDFC will perform well. State of Maharashtra is also performing well. And Savitri Jindal is also performing well. After a point of time, now what happened? There is a certain situation wherein Vijay Mallya has been declared as bankrupt and he is not having any sum of money. So what was his expectation? What the industry or what the company was expecting? That 100 crores of rupees will be raised from Vijay Mallya. But as on today, he is not giving or paying back that certain sum of money. So what happened? The entire project gets collapsed and accordingly, the project comes to a standstill situation wherein the project cannot go further also and the project cannot go backward also. So in this way, to identify the risk with respect to the investor also, that is, what is the amount that has to be raised, whether the amount will be utilized or whether it will not be utilized, whether the amount will be raised or it will not be raised, and so on. The common lending norms. Now, depending on the individual perspectives or the individual concerns, the lending norms of different peoples or different countries are different. Now, if this particular amount has been raised from the Indian government, the norms are different. Different participants, that is, if you are raising a certain sum of money from US, you are raising a certain sum of money from Europe or Australia, then depending on the different countries, the rules also changes, the guidelines also changes, the policy framework, everything changes. So what are the lending norms with respect to the banking scenario? What are the various lending norms with respect to the private or the individual money lenders, and so on. The fifth point is the concern of the uniform rate of interest. Now, uniform rate of interest is a particular situation wherein you have to identify and you have to consider what is the prevailing rate of interest in the particular economy. Now, this particular project, if it is into the Indian origin or the Indian economy, then the prevailing rates that has been provided by the Reserve Bank of India applies to the Indian origin. So, Reserve Bank of India ki policy kya chal rahi hai? What are the various rates of CRR, SLR, repo and reverse repo? And according to this, what are the various holding pattern of a particular amount of money? That is, what is the amount that has been held or remaining with the bankers? What is the amount with the general public? What is the amount with the traders? What is the amount with the investors? And what is the rate of liquidity? That is, what SLR, statutory liquidity rate. That is, in what duration the amount has been liquidated or the amount has been flow into the general economy. So, identification of the rate of interest, that is, what is the base that has been provided, what is the rate of interest for the industrial economy, what is the rate for the government economy, what is the rate for the personal interest, and so on, or the personal loan, industrial loan, corporate loan, business loan, industrial loan, and so on. So, at every stage or every point of time, the rate of interest keeps on differing, and accordingly, the identification of common or the uniform rate of interest has also needed to be identified. Next perspective, sixth point is the consideration of the common loan documents. Now, the amount that we are raising of 1,000 crore, it is going to be raised from different vendors. There are participants, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 6 people are coming together and they are raising or they are contributing to a certain sum of money. And accordingly, 1,000 crore amount of money is to be raised. Now, whenever we are looking for the loan or the documentation purpose, that there should be a proper similarity in all the procedure of the formality that you are going for. That is, if you are asking for all the statements of accounts, then a proper statement of accounts of all 5 years has to be asked. कि अगर आपने कहा है कि मुझे से SBI का 5 साल का डेटा चाहिए तो SBI के साथ आपको HDFC का, विजय माल्या का, महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट का, सावित्री जिंदल का या रिलायंस इंडस्ट्रीज का, सबका 5 साल का डेटा कलेक्ट करना है एंड नॉट एनी डिफरेंशिएशन हैज टू बी शोन. If you are going for the conduction or the collection of data of the PAN card, Aadhaar card, documentation with respect to the balance sheet and so on. So all the documents has to be there in a similarity perspective and accordingly it has to be collected and properly filed with the SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. After collection of all these documents, you have to check and verify that it has to be properly submitted, it has to be properly verified and a proper approval has to be taken with respect to the state government, central government, the SEBI authority and the Reserve Bank of India and the respective banking authority and the proper board of directors. So, agar ye pura project RIL handle kar raha hai, to proper board of directors ka approval bhi aapko lena zaruri hai and then only a proper agenda and minutes of meeting can be passed, a proper resolution has also to be done and then only the project can be monitored or it can be started. The next point is consideration of common monitoring. Now, monitoring perspective with respect to the your beginning of project, your completion of project, your stages of project, your periodicity level, your repayment of interest, your repayment of principal, and so on. So a proper monetary system has to be there into existence, wherein at every stage or every point of time, you are looking into the consideration about what the project has been going for and how it has been followed. Keep proper aapka follow-up chart. या नहीं आपका प्रोजेक्ट उसी डायरेक्शन में उसी बोर्ड में कैरी फॉरवर्ड हो रहा है या नहीं हो रहा है. ऑल द प्रॉपर मॉनिटरिंग अथॉरिटी हैज टू बी देयर इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस. नेक्स्ट कंसीडरेशन इज द एनहांसिंग द लेंडिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज. सो व्हाट आर द वेरियस लेंडिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज दैट आर मेड अवेलेबल विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अ पर्टिकुलर कंसीडरेशन एंड इन व्हाट ड्यूरेशन द लेंडिंग इज देयर इनटू एग्जिस्टेंस. दैट इज इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर अ लोन नॉन कोऑपरेटिव government authority, state government, central government, all the lending authorities or the opportunities has to be taken into consideration, and accordingly we have to identify about what are the various different options or opportunities that are available for us. Here, for example, now our prohibition or our projection was HDFC will provide the loan opportunity or the loan amount of rupees 350 crore. So agar HDFC humko 350 crore de raha hai aur agar unka rate of interest 4% hai, so we have to identify at the different sources or different opportunities also. That is, if ICICI is there into existence, Axis Bank is there into existence, and if they are providing you the rate of interest is 3.5 or 3.8, then what feasibility or what option we have to take for. So accordingly, the different lending opportunities, that is different options also has to be identified, and the proper opportunity which is beneficial to the organization in the long run, that has to be selected as and when the need arises. Next perspective, generally considered as a safe lending option. So whichever option is very safe for you, whichever option is beneficial for you, it is profitable for you, only those option has to be considered, and accordingly the project or the advancement or the loan syndication process has to be taken forward. Next concern is the providing opportunity for increasing the fee based income. So at every stage or every point of time, there is a proper amount of fee that has to be charged. That is, the RIL, SBI, HDFC, a particular person or a particular government, everyone will charge you a certain rate of commission or a rate of interest or a rate of processing fee. So what is the rate of processing fee? That also has to be identified. What is their expected rate of return? That is, if you are approaching for the State Bank of India, then what is the expected rate of the interest? Payback period. Whether they are expecting the payback period to be 10 years, 12, 11 years, 12 years, 15 years. What is the payback period for an individual company and an individual associate or a corporate? That also has to be identified. Accordingly, the project has to be completed or started with. Next concern is the secure for loan syndication process by the merchant banker. Now, how does the merchant banker initiates in completion of this particular process of loan syndication? Scout the opportunities for engaging the high value funding. So the major perspective or the major role of the merchant banker in this particular stage is to identify what are the various opportunities for raising this particular sum of money. So for example, if as on today Axis Bank is appointed as a merchant banker for this particular project, so what Axis Bank will do? Axis Bank will identify the various options or various opportunities and wherein the various investors are made available and they are ready to invest into this particular project. So they have to take a particular decision whether this particular amount has to be raised from the money market, whether it has to be raised from the capital market, whether it has to be raised from a primary market, secondary market, banking institution, financial institution, loan syndication, and so on. So what are the various different options that have been available for you, and what is also the involvement of risk at this perspective? Discuss with the various project promoters about the entire project and kind of structure of the credit need. So always a proper discussion has to be has to be there into consideration with respect to the promoters also. So as I have said earlier, you have to take the proper approval from the board of directors, the chairman, and the management authority, and then only the project has to be continued for the completion purpose. So unless and until there is a proper permission or the prior approval from all the vendors or all the board of directors and all the members of the organization, the project is not to be taken into further, and the project has not to be started. Obtain the mandate from the company to syndicate the loan. So proper approval and the proper information has to be given to all the participants. That is, what is the type of loan that we are looking for, in what way the amount will be raised, and how the amount will be syndicated. Now, what is the concept of syndication? That is, from which various contributors the loan will be raised for. So everyone as a certain participant. Now, there is a particular participant called as Mr. Akshay. Now, Mr. Akshay must be knowing, or he must be aware of this particular fact, that my amount, whatever amount that I am contributing for. Now, Mr. Akshay, if he is contributing for 50 crore, he must have a certain knowledge that the amount of 100 crore has been raised by RIL, 150 crore is raised by SBI. HDFC is providing 350. Vijay Mallya is providing 100. Maharashtra government is providing 100, and so on. So proper information of the syndication, that is, who are the contributors to your loan category and in what ways the amount has to be, in what way the amount has been contributed. Every information has to be given to all the participants. You have to properly study the DPR. The DPR is a detailed project report prepared by the technical consultant. So whatever the report about the feasibility of the project, that is, before starting a particular project, what we do, we properly prepare a DPR, that is, detailed project feasibility report, and we have to identify whether the project is feasible or not feasible, whether the project is comfortable, or whether the NOC has been taken from the environment authorities or the environment ministry, whether there is no harm to the general public, whether there is no harm to the nature, and so on. So all the feasibility project report has to be properly studied, and the technical consultation has to be taken into consideration, wherein there is proper NOC from all the authorities into existence. So based on the DPR, you have to draw the project information memorandum, that is PIM. Now, what is a memorandum? Memorandum is a particular situation wherein all the conditions, terms, authorities, policies, guidelines has been provided, in what way the project will be completed, in what way the project will be executed, and in what duration the project will be completed. So all the information regarding the roles, responsibilities, powers, authorities, duties of each and every member, each and every participant, the rate of contributors, or that is the rate of percentage of contribution, percentage of profit margin, percentage of output orientation, and so on. So all these information has to be there into consideration and involved in the project information memorandum. And lastly, identification of the SWOT analysis. So in consideration of the SWOT analysis, all the components or the participants comes into consideration, wherein you have to identify what is your strength, weakness, opportunity, and threats of that particular project. What is the benefit of the project? What are the various weaknesses of that particular project? How this particular project will be beneficial to the society, to the government, to the nature, to the organizations, and so on. So what are the various benefits in the short term? What are the various benefits in the long term, and so on. So So all this consideration has to be there into existence, and accordingly we have to identify whether the project will be feasible or whether the a situation wherein if any one of them has not agreed to it, so what will be considered? So if at any stage or any point of time, one, now for example, there is a certain situation wherein Savitri Jindal, now Savitri Jindal is a particular participant, and she's providing you amount of rupees 350 crore. Now taking this example, now if she says that, okay, if I want to give, or if I am ready to give 350 crore for this particular project, I want a certain return of at least 5%, and the project duration must be in terms of 12 years. So if any party or if any participant is not accepting to the certain terms and conditions, then what a particular trader or what a particular merchant banker can do, he can identify the particular person who is either a certain situation wherein and another option or another substitute can be identified, or the company has to revise the project at an entire origination. That is, jo aapne earlier DPR banaya tha, that is the detailed project report that has been prepared by the technical consultant, again you have to revise this particular project, again you have to reframe or redraft the PIM, that is project information memorandum, and then based on the revisions or based on the suggestion that has been provided by any of the participant, you have to completely revise the project. Now if you don't want to revise this particular project, then you have to identify a new source, you have to identify a new trader, and accordingly based on the new terms and conditions, the project has to be reframed or it has to be reconsidered. Loan syndication process. So circulate the PIM, circulate the memorandum among the banks and the financial institutions. Now, majorly, what is the situation that has been identified? That is, in most of the cases, the amount that has been required for the loan syndication, it is usually raised from the different banking authorities or the banks and the financial institution. That is NABARD, CRISIL, ICRA, and the various financial institutions which are ready to provide the financing, just only specifically for project finance and trade finance purposes. So you have to properly identify which are the various authorities who are ready to give the financing for the different projects, and based on the availability of these particular projects or the financing authorities, you can approach those organizations. Now in this particular example, what I have done, I have taken the example of Vijay Mallya and Savitri Jindal. Now these are the particular two participants who are an individual investors. So what we can see basically in the normal terms and conditions or in general scenario, individual investors are usually not preferred, and we usually go for the various banking authorities only. Why? Because there is high involvement of risk. So if a particular person becomes insolvent or a particular bankrupt, then entire project may collapse, and accordingly the financing process may stop at any point of time. So we have to identify what are the various participants, and accordingly the project is usually given for the various banking authorities or the financial institutions only. After a few days, convene a meeting to the promoters with the banks and the financial institution to get the complete information about the project. So as I have said earlier, that is, you have to properly conduct a meeting with the board of directors, the promoters, the chairman, and all the participants of your merchant banking or the loan syndication process. So you have to take a proper meeting with all these particular participants, and you have to give them the complete information about what is the project, where is the site located, during what duration the project will be completed, what is the amount that has been raised, from which sources the amount has been raised, who are the various participants, and you have to and what marketing strategies that you are going to apply for. Now in the sense, you have to aapka project successful karna hai to aapko uski utni publicity bhi karna zaruri hai, aapko uske liye utne investors bhi find karna zaruri hai. Now take another situation wherein if you are going to raise this certain sum of money from capital market or money market perspective. मनी मार्केट में आपके सारे बैंकिंग अथॉरिटीज और फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस आ गए, लेकिन अगर आपको कैपिटल मार्केट में जाना है, सो इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर अ कैपिटल मार्केट, देन यू हैव एन सर्टेन ऑप्शन दैट इज एन आईपीओ, दैट इज इनिशियल पब्लिक ऑफरिंग. सो इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर एन ऑप्शन फॉर एन आईपीओ, देन व्हाट इज द सिचुएशन, यू हैव टू कंपलसरी गो विद द जनरल पब्लिक, एंड द जनरल पब्लिक इफ दे इन्वेस्ट देन ओनली द अमाउंट कैन बी रेज. Now, if you are going for an IPO, what you have to do, you have to properly market your product, you have to give the information to the respective trade investors or the retail investors, and the proper marketing of the goods and services also has to be done. So aapko yahan pe marketing bhi karna bahut zaruri hai, so that the project or the information is been raised to the general public, and each and every participants or the components of the general public is ready to raise or invest into this particular project. Next, another situation. Now, if it has been required, there is a certain condition that has been raised, arranged for a site visit to familiarize the banks and the financial institution. Now you must be heard that whenever normal terms and conditions में आपने क्या देखा है कि कभी भी जब आप बैंक आपको एक लोन देती है तो फिजिकली द बैंक विजिट्स दैट पर्टिकुलर साइट. कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर द लोन फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर फ्लैट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू परचेज अ पर्टिकुलर फ्लैट और पर्टिकुलर रो हाउस और पर्टिकुलर बंगलो, द बैंक फिजिकली विजिट्स दैट पर्टिकुलर लोकेशन, दे प्रॉपरली इंस्पेक्ट दैट पर्टिकुलर साइट, एंड आफ्टर द प्रॉपर इंस्पेक्शन ओनली दे disburse that particular loan only. For example, now whenever you, if a few of your students must have taken the educational loan also. Now what does the particular bank do? They properly cross check the information. वो आपके कॉलेज में फोन करेंगे, वो आपके कॉलेज के डॉक्यूमेंट चेक करेंगे, वो आपके कॉलेज के सारे एडमिशन का फी रिसीट है या नहीं, आपका एडमिशन हुआ या नहीं हुआ, ये सारी इंफॉर्मेशन चेक करेंगे, और फिर ही आपका बैंक लोन जो आपका एजुकेशन लोन या वो पास किया जाएगा. Now if you are going for a vehicle loan, they also check all these particular documents, they properly inspect that particular vehicle whether it has been purchased or not purchased, and then only the amount has been disbursed. So identify, so think of a particular situation wherein if this is a particular situation for a small scale business, then what is a particular situation for a loan syndication. Agar aapki project ki value 1000 crore hai ya aapki project ki value 10000 crore, if it is 10000 crore, what type of inspection can be done? So for a proper feasibility, what a particular merchant banker has to do, so it is a duty and responsibility of a particular merchant banker that he has to take all these particular participants to the particular site. Unke liye proper aapko site visit organize karna hai, and you have to give the complete information about what the project will be and how the various resources will be utilized or implemented in completion of this particular project. The banks and the financial institution to approach their higher authorities for obtaining the necessary sanction. So whenever this particular information has been given to them, then what will the bank do, depending on the branch that you have applied for, ki aapne kaun se branch mein particular project ke liye apply kiya hai, then they will approach the different locations, that is wo apne zonal manager ke paas jayenge, zonal manager regional manager ke paas jayega, regional manager aapka state level state head ke paas jayega, state head aapka national head ke paas jayega, aur wo national head jab tak aapko chairman of that particular bank ki permission nahi milti hai, the loan will not be sanctioned and the loan will not be passed. So accordingly all the higher authorities of the banking has to be there into loop, and accordingly the proper approval from all the authorities has to be taken accordingly. Upon receipt of the sanction from all the banks and financial institutions, allocate the limit to the lenders on pro rata basis. Now what is this consideration of pro rata basis? Now State Bank of India ne kya kaha tha ki hum aapko 150 crore de rahe, HDFC ne kya kaha tha ki hum aapko 350 crore de rahe. do you think that all this particular sum of money will be given at once at a particular one? It is not at all possible. Why? Because no one bank or no single institution is ready to take a particular risk. That is, at a single go, the entire amount will be disbursed or the entire amount will be given for you. In your अगर आप फ्लैट के लिए आपका कोई घर के लिए भी लोन देते हो तो what does the bank give? What does the bank do? The bank gives you a certain sum of money in various installment. That is over a period of a span of 5 years, आपका amount different lots में या different installments में payment किया जाता है. In same case, 150 crore also will be given into different installments or different slots. That is on pro rata basis. That 20 crore in the first year, 50 crore in the second year, again 30 crore in the second year becomes 100 crore. That is 3 years has been completed. Again, they will provide a 10 crore in the fourth year and 40 crore in the last year, that is fifth year. So in this way, the amount is been disbursed in an equal installment, which has been mutually decided between the merchant banker and between the bank. And accordingly, the sanctioning of the loan also has been allocated into different limits. So har ek bank ke paas apne apne limits hai, and depending on the terms and conditions, depending on the mutual agreement, depending on the PIM, that is a memorandum that you have signed, the amount has been disbursed and accordingly the amount has been provided to the various financial institutions. Achieving the financial closure. So at every stage or point of time, now if your particular loan amount has been disbursed or it has been given at a complete position, so at this end also you have to take a proper closure letter from this particular bank, and accordingly a proper undertaking has also to be signed that whatever the amount that has been sanctioned, whether the amount is 150 crore or 50 crore or over 350 crore, entire amount has been disbursed from XYZ bank to the XYZ organization, and accordingly the loan amount is being settled and there is a financial closure of transaction. So जैसे आपका फाइनेंशियल क्लोजर ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन होता है, व्हाट हैपन आफ्टर दिस स्टेज, व्हाट हैपन द अमाउंट ऑफ रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट स्टार्ट्स, दैट इज द बैंक विल स्टार्ट टू चार्ज यू अ सर्टेन रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एंड अकॉर्डिंगली योर रीपेमेंट प्रोसेस स्टार्ट्स एट दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस और एट दिस पर्टिकुलर पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. Now, at any stage or any point of time, if there is certain consideration of the legal authorities or the legal intervention, then you have to approach the legal authorities also, and accordingly, the proper approval or the verification of the documents from the legal perspective. That is, if any litigation arises, then you have to approach the different court matters. That is, either the district authorities, district court, state court, high court, national court, or the Supreme Court of India, and accordingly, the issue or the process has to be resolved as and when it is been required. Get the loan document executed by all the banks and the financial institutions. So proper approval or the confirmation of the loan document has to be there, and appointment of a security trustee. Now this particular security trustee, when you will require this particular security trustee? Now if you are going for a concept of IPO raising or the money raising from the capital market, so if you are approaching the capital market, then you have to appoint a merchant banker, and this particular merchant banker specifically appoints a security trustee. That is, they act as a particular person who is called as an underwriter. Now, underwriter क्या करेगा? Underwriter takes a certain guarantee. Now, this particular amount of 1000 crore that you are raising for example, if you are raising a certain sum of money of rupees 400 crore from the capital market or from IPO. Now, what is this particular role of the underwriter? Underwriter आपका क्या करेगा? Underwriter will take a certain guarantee or a certain authority that if the amount is not been raised, if the amount is not been raised from the general public, he will contribute to this particular sum of money that has been required. So that particular person is called as a security trustee, or the security of trustee is also called as an underwriter. Take a certain situation or example, ki whenever this particular 400 crore has to be raised from the general public or from the capital market, what happened? In actual scenario, only 310 crore was been raised from the capital market or from the issue of IPO. Now, what is the balance amount? The balance amount is 190 crore. That is zero. Now, balance amount of 190 crore. Now, who will pay or who will raise this certain sum of money of 190 crore? It is the duty, it is the responsibility, or it is the proper confirmation, or it is the proper responsibility of the security trustee, or it is the responsibility of the underwriter to raise this certain sum of money, or 190 crore proper underwriter ko dena padta hai, and he will pay this certain sum of money. So 310 crore raised from the capital market, that is IPO, and 190 crore that has been given by the underwriter or the security trustee, and total of 400 crore or 300 or 500 crore amount will be raised by the loan syndication process. So in this way, the amount of process or the transaction is been completed step by step, whatever is been required. Creating a security in favor of lenders. So always at every stage or point of time, we have to see that a proper security is been provided to the various lenders who are whosoever is contributing to your organization, whosoever is contributing to your particular project, उनको हमको सबको security provide करना है. That is, we have to give them a proper assurance that your money is being secured with us, and at every stage or point of time, the amount will not go into losses at any stage, whatever may be the situation. So, whatever may be the ups and downs in the market, whether there is a situation of inflation or deflation, whether there is an unemployment or unemployment into existence, whether the market goes up or goes down, whether there is an flexibility or stability in the market, our project will be successful and your amount or the money that you have invested will be at a very secured level. Appoint lead lenders or engineers for conducting the periodical inspection. So whenever the particular project starts, at every stage or point of time, what we have to do, you have to see that you appoint a proper inspection engineer. Now, this particular inspection engineer, what he will do at every stage or every point of time, he will check, he will proper identify the feasibility of the project, and as per the terms and conditions or as per the norms, whether the project is completing, whether the project is not completing, whether the project is done in a various favorable point of time or not, he has to check at every stage or every point of time, and accordingly he has to prepare a progress report. So a proper progress report of either 1 month duration, 3 month duration or 6 month duration has to be prepared, and the progress report has to be submitted with the merchant banker, and in return the merchant banker submits this particular project with the SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India, and gives them the proper information about what is the status or progress of the project that has been there into existence. Now, same case as in you have prepared your progress report for the summer internship, wherein you are giving the information to your guide, that is in the, that during 8 days what you have done or what task has been undertaken by you. So in the same way, the particular project manager has to also give, the project lead engineer has to also give a proper information about the inspection of this particular project. That is, he has to physically approach that particular site. He has to check whether the authorities, whether the norms, whether the qualitative and quantitative methods have been applied or not, and the project has been completed in the specified time duration. That is, whatever the task has been assigned, whatever the task that was being expected, whether it has been completed or not, and if it is lagging, then why the project is lagging at this stage. Convene the periodical meeting of the lenders and including the unit visits. So frequent visits during either for the 3 months or the 6 months has to be organized, and accordingly the periodical meeting between all the participants. कि जितने कितने लोगों ने जिस किसी ने आपके प्रोजेक्ट में इन्वेस्ट किया है उनके साथ आपको प्रॉपर मीटिंग कंडक्ट you have to conduct a proper meeting, and accordingly the information of either the agenda and the minutes of meeting has to be properly communicated with them. So accordingly the proper information you have to give to them, and you have to provide information about what is the status of the project that is completion. Now in what stage the project has been completed, whether it is in a favorable position, unfavorable position, whether it is going as per the terms and conditions or as per the norms or not. So accordingly the information to all the participants, all the traders or the merchant bankers has to be provided, and all the investors it is to be given time to time. Completion. Now commercial operation date. So according to the commercial operation date, you have to also identify. Now whenever you have prepared a proper feasibility report, in this particular feasibility what we do, we have to properly set a guidelines for this particular project also. That is, during first 6 months what amount of project will be completed. Just a minute. सुन रहे ना सब? हेलो,
यस सर,
ओके. शेयरिंग स्क्रीन इज नॉट पॉसिबल. Okay, starting going back now, loan syndication process, we were there. So proper of commercial operation date, so identification of the commercial operation. That now whenever you have prepared your feasibility report, in this particular feasibility report you properly state the guidelines or the proper state the proper deadlines about to in during in what format the particular work has to be completed and in what duration the task has to be also to be completed. That is 10% of project will be completed in first 6 months, 20% of the project gets completed in next 6 months, 50% of the project gets completed in the 60 months, and so on. So accordingly you have to identify proper how many months is been required for completion of what percentage of work, and 100% of work will be completed in what amount of month that has been specifically. So accordingly you have to specify, and accordingly you have to see that whether the deadlines have been followed or not followed, and the commercial operation date, that is whatever the date that you have specified. That is, if the date is 31st of March of 2020, then as on this particular date, whether the project has been completed or not completed, and if it has not been completed, what are the various drawbacks or what are the various loopholes due to which the project is not completed. So in this way, proper identification, proper study of the report has to be done, and it has to be kept as a proper record. Appoint an escrow agent or an escrow account with the bank. So now what is the consideration of the escrow agent or an escrow account? It is specifically maintained by a particular merchant banker to control the various promotion of these particular transactions. Now consider a situation wherein we have approached State Bank of India, and State Bank of India, the requirement or the proposition of the loan was rupees 150 crore. Now, जो आपने 150 करोड़ रुपीज ऑफ अमाउंट मांगा था स्टेट बैंक ऑफ व्हाट यू आर एक्सपेक्टिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट विल बी इन्वेस्टर और दिस पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट विल बी गिवन फॉर यू इन डिफरेंट इंस्टॉलमेंट्स. समवन हैज स्टार्टेड द मीटिंग अगेन. Okay, so this particular amount will be received by the State Bank of India in different installment. But in actual scenario, what happened? The entire amount of 150 crore was given at one go by the State Bank of India, and the amount has been received by the merchant banker. So if an extra amount has been received by a particular investor or by a particular trader, then what he has to do? He has to deposit the certain sum of money with the escrow account, and accordingly the escrow account will maintain the amount of money that is the that has been received by a particular vendor, and accordingly if any additional amount has been received, the amount will be kept as a deposit or kept in a safe locker with respect to the escrow account. Ensure repayment among the lenders in the prescribed manner. So in the proper prescribed manner, you have to see that you have to provide or make a provision about the repayment as a certain perspective also. That is, if your project gets completed after 10 years or 12 years, then what will be your mode or what will be your procedure for repayment of this particular loan? That is, in what installment you will be repaying, in what duration you will be repaying, at what rate of interest you will be repaying, and what will be the mode of repayment also. So all these formalities has to be identified, and it has to be taken into consideration whenever you are preparing or forming a particular project. Okay, any difficulty at this stage for understanding the process of merchant banking, underwriting, project financing, or the what we have seen right now, loan syndication? You can please unmute yourself and ask me the questions, or we'll move further with the concept of investment banking. Or you can drop the questions in the chat box also. I'll answer in from the chat history. Any questions? Okay, no questions. Now the second perspective we are starting with, second or third, whatever it may be. The next question or the next short note is with respect to the investment banking. So what does the investment banking mean? Now, as per the definition that has been provided, or the traditional meaning of investment banking, a financial intermediary that performs a variety of financial services. This includes underwriting, acting as an intermediary between an issuer of securities and the investing public, facilitating mergers and corporate reorganization, and acting as a broker for the institutional client. Now, In simple terms, now this particular definition is very confusing for you. In simple terms, I'll give you a certain example wherein what is an investment bank. Now, investment bank is a particular organization or a particular company, to be specific, a particular company which conducts all the activities that we have seen earlier. Now, what are the different activities we have seen? A merchant banker is there, a underwriter is there, a portfolio manager is there, or a security manager is there. And right now a loan syndicator was there, and so on. So if a particular organization or if a particular company which come forward and they conduct the activities of all these different performs or all the different functions, then this particular organization will be called as an investment banker. So the major role of the investment banker begins with the pre-underwriting counseling and continues with the distribution of securities in the form of advice. जैसे हमारा फर्स्ट सिनेरियो क्या था, द फर्स्ट सिनेरियो, द फर्स्ट सिचुएशन वाज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द मर्चेंट बैंकर. सो व्हाट डज द मर्चेंट बैंकर डू? इफ यू वांट टू रेज अ सर्टेन सम ऑफ मनी फ्रॉम द जनरल पब्लिक, सो हाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट विल बी रेज्ड? राइट फ्रॉम द इशू फ्रॉम द कॉर्पोरेट इक्विटी और द कॉर्पोरेट एंटिटी, फ्रॉम द कैपिटल मार्केट, मनी मार्केट, डेट मार्केट, इक्विटी मार्केट, सिक्योरिटीज मार्केट एंड सो ऑन. So considering all the market situation and completion the process of loan syndication. So all the participants coming from the merchant banking to the loan syndication, agar ye sare process ek hi aadmi, ek hi banda, ek hi company agar kaam karti hai, so this particular organization or company will be called as an investment banker. So investment banking is a field of banking that aids companies in acquiring the funds. Now this particular acquiring of funds can be from different sources or different resources. That is, you can raise a certain sum of money from capital market, money market, bank, shareholders, investors, money lenders, private entities, stock market, equity market, debenture market, bond market, capital market, multi-commodity exchange, international market, domestic market, and so on. So these are the different types of markets wherein the amount can be raised. But what does the investment banking do? The investment banking provides you a certain feasibility or a certain option wherein they approaches different participants, different vendors, and accordingly they facilitate to provide a certain sum of money from the different sourcing agencies. So in addition to the acquisition of new fund, investment banking also applies or offers advices for the existing transactions also. So if you are looking for an existing investors, so for this particular consideration also, the investment banking can provide you the financial activity for an existing project also. So agar aapka koi project hai jo abhi newly existing nahi hai but existing project hai, to uske liye bhi aapko additional sum of money can be provided by the investment banker. Does not also does a large amount of consulting. So majorly at the every stage, now as in simultaneous consultation with the amount of raising a certain sum of money, what does the merchant banking do? The merchant banking also provides consultancy services to the different participants of the stock market or the equity, debenture, bond market. So if any of the person needs a certain amount of consultation or the consultation about the feasibility of the project, successful of the project, payback period or the returns of this particular project, then the investment banker also provides the consultation services also. They give companies advice on the mergers and acquisitions. So if the companies want a certain consultation services with respect to the mergers and acquisitions, then those services also are being provided. That is, if two companies want to come together or if two or more companies want to merge together, then those are different perspectives or the formalities of how this particular process will be completed, what are the various steps or norms that has to be provided or has to be undertaken, all these services or the guidance or the compliances are also undertaken by the investment bankers. They also track the market in order to give the advice on the public offering also. That is, as I have said earlier, that is for the initial public offering also. So for the consideration of the IPO services, the investment bankers can also come forward and provide you the services with respect to the buying and selling of securities on the existing market also or the new issue market also. So they can identify the various brokers, participants, mediators, money lenders, and the amount can be raised from the general public. That is either from the IPO, that is the initial public offering, which is a primary market, or you can approach the secondary market also. The line between the investment banking and other forms of banking is very similar or regular. Now it is as usual as a part of deregulation. So at this stage, every stage, now what happened in respect to the banking perspective, you have a specific consideration of the norms that has been provided by this SEBI or the Reserve Bank of India. But in terms of the investment banking, there are very few or the less number of norms that is there into existence, and it is quite a type of a deregulated market. So there is no proper regulation with respect to the investment banking, and it is very complicated. Created a certain scenario wherein the investment bankers are given a certain feasibility, that is you can raise a certain sum of money from different participants also. The investment banking definition is more driven by the American concept and evolved during the last one century. So in the last century, that is 19th and 20th century, the concept of investment banking came into existence, wherein large scale of industries were started to expansion and they have to raise a certain sum of money from different sources or different resources. The functions of investment banking. Now, these are the various multilateral functions that you can see at this particular stage. So the functions are issuing the securities, primary market, either from the private market, guaranteeing by standing the underwriting, best efforts selling and foreign exchange market. So now the another situation now as on today, what we see, the amount of investment banking or the merchant banking services can be into existence of the foreign exchange or the currency market also. So if you want to raise a certain sum of money into the international market in terms of the dollar currency, euro currency, yen currency, pound currency, and so on. So for raising a certain sum of money into the international currency transaction, the investment banking services are also made available at this stage. Other services include acting as an intermediary in trading for clients. So if you want to provide the trading facility to the different clients also, then for trading these particular services also, they can act as an intermediary. So a particular relationship or a particular chain between a particular trader or a particular client or a particular service provider or a particular client. So a proper link can also be created, and accordingly, a chain of distribution can be created between two parties or two or more parties. They provide the financial advices to the investors by assisting in purchasing the securities, managing the financial assets and trading of securities. So now, for example, if there is a particular person called Mr. Shreyas, and Mr. Shreyas needs a certain guidance or a certain information about where the amount has to be invested, in which portfolio the amount has to be invested, what will be the rate of return, what should be the holding period, and what will be the exit period, what is the stop loss situation. So all these information can be provided by the investment banker, and accordingly for purchasing and selling the securities also, the investment banker can provide you or can give you the information for dealing in the financial assets or trading securities. The last point you can see, the investment banking differs from the financial commercial banking. So yes, now commercial banking, what does it do? They specifically conduct the two activity, that is accepting of deposits and granting of loan. So the traditional function or the major function of the commercial banks are accepting deposit and granting of loan. But apart from the commercial banking, the investment banking is looking for the various different types of services in correlation with the merchant banking or the investment banking. So in this way, all the feasibility services of the commercial banking and investment banking are quite different. Evolution of merchant banking. So as we have seen, so since the last scenario, that is the after the First World War, wherein the banking function has started to expand. After the First World War, the various companies also started to expand their business. There was the major thrust that was been given for the industrialization, and accordingly, that is the World War I situation was between from 1915 to 1918, and accordingly, since 1920 onwards, the investment banking function started to establish or expand. The evolution of merchant banking is investment banking is from the scenario of the United States, that is from the economy of US, and accordingly, as and when the capital market started to boom, the various investment bankers came into existence. The first acquisition of the company took place in 1920 when the National City Bank of New York acquired Hessler, Stewart and Company. So these are the various two in banker that was there in existence, and whenever these particular two organization, that is National City Bank of New York and Hessler, Stewart Company, they merged together and they form a new organization, and their new company was being registered as an investment banker. So booming of the 1920 economy, wherein the various selling of the Yankee bonds was there into existence, and accordingly the selling of the currency into the international market, expansion of the business or expansion of the industry at the global level or the international started to expand day by day. Evolution of the investment banking, it has been seen there are various participants or the similar activities of the commercial banking is also there, wherein they are accepting the money for the raising of fund also, and they are granting the loan, that is they are disbursing the amount of money for the project appraisal or the project feasibility purpose also. So they have become the as a certain situation wherein they are accepting the money also and they are granting the loans also, and apart from these two traditional activities, they are dealing with the different types of services or the different types of activities wherein the assistance to the retail investors, assist to the investors of the global trading concern, assistance for the mergers and acquisition, assistance for raising the money from the general market or the capital market or the money market. At every stage, all these particular types of services have been provided by the investment banker. The stock market was overheated. Now, this particular situation started to grow day by day. And since 1929 onwards, what we can see, there was a certain situation wherein there was a bankruptcy of the various banks in the United States. So after the bankruptcy in the United States, again, the new act was been passed. That is the Bank Legislation Act of the 1933. And the Glass-Steagall Act was also there into existence. So these are the particular traditional act that was been passed in the U.S. economy, and accordingly for protection the rights of the investment bankers, for protection, for boosting the economy at the national level or the international level, the various measures has been taken by the central government or the state government authorities that are there into existence. Another extension of the evolution of the merchant banking. So this concept, this is all the theoretical perspective of the investment banking. I'll mail it all these particular slides to you. You can go back and refer those particular slides. Now, in 1973, the various Arabian crisis of the embargo and how the oil crisis has been impacted the growth and establishment of the merchant banking, industrial and financial services. So investment banking also provides the services or the financial assistance to the industrial sectors or the industrial economists and the financial services sector also. Development of the investment and commercial banking became constrained, which necessitated for the relaxation of the various norms of the act. So in this way, various acts was also being passed wherein the various rules, regulations was being made in order to provide a successful and stability into this particular market also. So at every share point of time, what we have seen, there is no feasibility, there is no instability into this particular market. And whatever the amount that they are looking for, whatever the amount that they want to raise, the project gets completed in a specific period of time. And accordingly, the feasibility has been completed. Accordingly, the project provides a proper rate of return to all the participants. And there is no drawback at any stage or any point of time. For the scenario with respect to the evolution of investment banking, for the scenario of 1980s, 2008 and 2000 era or the 2000 scenario. So US is a huge investment financial market wherein the functions of the commercial banks are distinct from that of investment banking. So in terms of the US economy, that is in terms of USA, there is a proper distinction or proper identification has been given with respect to the functions of a commercial banker and functions of an investment banker. So a proper clarification has been provided about what activities a merchant banker has to undertake, what activities of an investment bank has to undertake, and what activities the commercial bank has to undertake. So in this way, all the rights and duties have been specifically provided, and everyone has to conduct their activities in their respective origination or in their respective norms or the guidelines that has been provided. Functions of IB is more akin to the functions of merchant banking. So in extension to the relationship, you can see that most of the activity that have been conducted by the merchant banking in a general perspective or at the major perspective, all these different types of activities have been conducted or are been are into operational by the investment banking that is there into existence. So there is much similarity between the investment banker and a merchant banker. In the Indian context, these IBs can be termed as FII. So from the Indian perspective, now IB, that is investment banking, is a term that has been majorly used in US economy. But in terms of the Indian economy, from the Indian perspective or the Indian origin, the term that has been majorly used or in similar to use is the FII, that is foreign institutional investors, wherein a foreign institutional investor can be either an institution, can be either an individual, or which is either from the participant, which is either a domestic person or an international or a multilateral person into existence. Now, a proper distinction between a merchant banker and investment banker is given in this particular slide. So as we have seen, the United States called as an investment banks, the UK, that is United Kingdom, or the European economy called is as an accepting and issuing houses. So at different places or different locations, there are different names for the different organization. US mein wo kya kehlata hai, US mein wo kehte ki they call it as an investment banker. In UK or in Europe, they call it as an accepting and issuing houses. In Indian economy, they call it as a merchant banker or FII, and so on. So in general, the merchant banks are the financial institution which provide the financial services, solution and advices to corporate houses and some of the world famous merchant banks. So which are the various most world famous banks? That is the Goldman Sachs, the Credit Suisse, Morgan Stanley, JP Morgan Chase, and so on. So you must have heard these different types of organizations, and they act as a merchant banker for providing the different types of financial services in the international market or into the domestic market. In India, there are various banks which are into field of merchant banking, and the different banking authorities or the merchant bankings in Indian origin are ICICI, that is Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India, State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, and so on. HDFC is also there, Axis Bank is also there, and different body corporates or associates of SBI, that is sub-participants of the SBI, are also having the different merchant banking authorities into existence. So, similar rights or similar activities have been conducted by the merchant banker and the investment banker, wherein you have to remember that merchant bank is a minor concept, whereas investment bank is a major concept. More of the activities have been conducted by the investment banker and smaller activities have been conducted by the merchant banker. MB and IB in their pursuit forms are different kinds of financial institution that perform different services, though the functional tends to blur. So maybe their functions are same, that is whatever the activity that they are conducting are same, but their methods of conduction, methods of financial institution is completely different. Unke rights, authorities, duties totally different hai, lekin wo jo kaam karte, wo sare kaam bahut similar hai. So in this way, there may be much similarity in the functions of merchant banker and investment banker, but their rights, authority, duties and responsibilities are quite different. So in this way, the difference between the IB and MB is been provided into this particular slide. Some of the activities may include issuing a letter of credit, transferring of fund, internationally trading, consulting, co-investment in projects, involvement trade in one or other form, and so on. So these are different types of activities which a merchant bank or an investment bank has to undertake. An investment banker is a total solution provided to a corporate desirous of mobilizing capital. So if a particular corporate is looking for raising a certain sum of money at the various large scale level or at a very huge amount of quantitative level, then you have to go for an approach option for an investment banker, and accordingly you can raise a certain sum of money from the perspective or from the origin of investment banker. A merchant banker could be defined as an organization that acts as an intermediary between the issuer and the ultimate purchasers of securities in the primary security market. So, considering the primary security market, so at every stage, jaise aapka normal terms and conditions, normal transactions hai, usi situation mein, you have to see that a proper merchant banker is there into existence who provide the money availability, who provides or who sees that the amount is made available from both the sources, that is from the capital market or money market also, either a primary market also or either from the secondary market into existence. Merchant banking activity provides a fee-based services, whereas the investment banking can be having a fee-based or non-fee-based services, wherein here you can see that is investment has a wider connotation with respect to the both, that is fund based and non fund based activity. A proper situation, so a merchant banker is having certain right and authority given by the SEBI, and they can properly charge you a certain sum of money. So depending on the amount of capital that you are raising for, whether it is 50 crore, 100 crore, 200 crore, 500 crore, according to your capital requirement, the amount of fees is being charged and what is the type of fund also. Whether you are raising the amount of money for the short-term term, medium-term term, long-term, and so on. So whether you are raising the money for the allied industry, whether you are raising for the money for the health industry, pharma industry, security industry, portfolio industry, financial services industry, garment industry, textile industry, and so on. So which is the different types of industry also that you are raising a certain sum of money. NFB includes advisory roles also, that is National Financing Board, and thus IB involves the merchant banking activity. So we have to there is a proper differentiation between the IB and MB, that is there into existence, and a proper distinction with respect to the trade with respect to the clients, with respect to the services is properly identified, and accordingly everyone conducts their business activities as per their need and as per their feasibility that is there into existence. Difference between IB and MB, major services that have been provided by merchant banker. So what are the various services that a particular merchant banker provides, and in what way the various services can be delivered to the different participants? Okay, any difficulty at this stage? Would you like to ask any questions? You can please ask. You can either question or drop your questions in the chat box also. Everybody is there listening? Please respond. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No questions? No questions. Okay. Now, major services provided by the merchant banker. You can see here the list of various services that a merchant bank provides. So, as per now, earlier you have seen the functions of merchant banker. So, in respect to the functions, there were around 15 to 20 functions a particular merchant banker has to perform. But with respect to the services, it is quite limited, and accordingly, the services may differ from person to person, individual to individual, country to country, state to state. So the role of the merchant banker in Indian economy is different, in US economy it is different, in European economy is different, and in different countries it may be different. So these particular services from the Indian perspective, that is first thing, is the consideration of the project counseling. So whatever may be the project, whether the project is a short-term term, medium-term, long-term term, so accordingly the merchant banker has to see that a proper counseling for the project completion has been provided, and whatever the guidelines that have been needed to be required, that is, if whether to invest, whether to not to invest, whether to start, not to start, whether to go or not to go, what are the various pros and cons, what are the SWOT analysis of this particular project, all the information regarding this particular project has been provided by the merchant banker, and a proper counseling session can be conducted by a merchant banker. Second situation is the concept of loan syndication. Now, in the current lecture also, we have entirely in detail, we have seen what is the concept of loan syndication. So I'm not going again back into detail. So what is just briefing, loan syndication, yani kya? Whenever you are going for raising a certain sum of money, and now if the particular amount of money is very huge or very high, that is, it is 500 crore, 1000 crore, 10,000 crore, then what do? A single investor or a single participant cannot come forward and raise this particular sum of money. So what do? You provide or you bring in different participants, and with the help of different participants, you start raising this certain sum of money. So when different participants, whether it is a bank or whether it is a financial institution, or whether it is a single or an individual investor, if the amount is being raised by a combination of different investors, that is, a combination of different investors is called as a syndicate, then this particular type of situation is called as a loan syndication. Another service, that is a manager to an issue. So manager to an issue is specifically related with the consideration or the concept of IPO, that is initial public offering. So agar aap money market ya capital market mein ja rahe ho, aur capital market mein if you are specifically going for the IPO or the primary market, then whenever you are going for an IPO situation, then you have to appoint a lead manager. Now this particular lead manager can be a merchant banker, and accordingly he can act as a manager to the issue also. So if the company is going for a fresh issue of the shares, then they can act as a lead manager also. Underwriting, I have also given you an example, or we have seen in detail who is an underwriter, wherein an underwriter takes a responsibility and authority, that is, if the issue is not subscribed, that is, if the issue is not being subscribed, then the underwriter takes a responsibility about repaying that particular sum of money on his own responsibility or on his own guarantee. So for example, consider a situation wherein a particular amount of 400 crore has to be raised for a certain project, and if only 310 crore has to be been raised from the primary market, then what an underwriter will do, the underwriter will provide 90 crore of amount from his own pocket, and he has to provide this particular amount of 90 crore from his own consideration. So an underwriter is a particular person, that is, if the issue is not being subscribed, then this particular amount is been provided by the underwriter himself. Next services is the portfolio management. So management of a particular portfolio, either it may be related to a particular project or either it may be related to a particular individual. Accordingly, for management of the investment pattern, that is, the particular amount of money, whether it has to be invested or whether particular amount of money, whether it has to be raised. So management of all these particular activities of a particular portfolio is also a type of service that has been undertaken by a merchant banker. Next situation is the non-resident investment, that is FII, NRI people. So if there is a certain situation, that is an NRI want to invest in your into your economy, then what are the various services that he is looking for, what are the various services that can be offered, what are the various options that can be given for him, and how the particular amount of money can be raised by these NRI. So if an NRI is coming and he wants to invest into your Indian economy, then you have to provide him a certain guidance about how this particular amount can be raised and what are the various platforms or resources in which this particular amount can be invested. Advising on mergers and takeovers. So if at any stage or point of time, if you want to conduct a merger and acquisition or a takeover of a particular firm, wherein two companies or two or more companies are coming together and they are forming either the merger or then either acquisition or the particular takeover is going to take place, then the merchant banker can also come forward and streamline all these activities. Arranging for offshore finances. So offshore finances, that is, if the particular finance has to be made available from the domestic economy or the international economy, then at this stage also the offshore financing is also made applicable, and accordingly the fund amount or the fundraising activity can be done by the merchant banker. And lastly, the corporate restructuring. If you want to completely restructure a particular industry or a particular firm, then the merchant banker can come forward and accordingly they can reframe the entire structure. I'll give a small example for you. Now in this scenario of 2005 to 2008, आपने देखा होगा कि एयर इंडिया जो था, no, एयर इंडिया was completely collapsed. There was no single person who was willing to travel from the Air India as a certain perspective. But after a point of time, what happened? This particular service industry, that is an Air India, all the authorities was been given, all the business was been transferred from one company to another company, wherein the involvement of the central government was been there to existence, and accordingly, the corporate restructuring of Air India was been done. After Air India, this particular company was bifurcated into Air India and Air India Express. Again, after the corporate restructuring, entire business was been handed over to Tata Airlines, and the new airline industry came into picture, wherein the Tata Group came forward and they started to restructure the Air India economy. That is, sorry, Air India as a certain business perspective or as a certain business model. And after a certain stage or a point of time, so from the year 2011, now Air India is functioning very well, and accordingly the company has been restructured. So the merchant banking can also come forward and take a certain activity of conducting a restructuring situation from a company perspective, from a government perspective, or from an investment perspective also. Who can be a merchant banker? Now, which are the various participants or which are the various components who can become a merchant banker? A public sector bank, a private sector bank, or an international bank can also be a merchant banker. Wherein, in the last slide, you must have seen an example, that is State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, ICICI, HDFC, Axis Bank, and so on. So public sector bank, that is State Bank of India and public State Bank of India or a Punjab National Bank, a public sector bank, private sector bank, I have given you an example, and an international bank, JP Morgan Chase, Stanley, Greenlace Bank, Hindustan Unilever, and so on. So international corporation also, individual company also, individual bank also, or individual financial institution. Everyone can be a merchant banker. A merchant banker can be either a bank, a financial institution, or an individual corporate also. Registration of merchant banker. So application for grant of certificate. So you have to make a proper application for the grant of certificate, and for whom the application kisko karna hai, the application has to be specifically done to the SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. So for proper granting of certificate, for proper granting of approval. Jaise in the form of Indian Companies Act, what do? You get a certain certificate called a certificate of incorporation, a certificate of commencement of business. Vaise in the same format or in the same situation, you have to take a proper application. You have to make a proper application for the SEBI, and accordingly, the certificate has to be taken for conducting or starting of business activities. Furnishing of information for clarification on any personal representation. So proper furnishing of information with respect to the who are the board of directors, who are the various members, and accordingly what will be the corporation or corporate fund that can be raised, and what will be the amount of fund that will be raised for. Now, whenever you have seen the different functions or the services that a particular merchant banker can perform, there are various services. So at the time of application also, you have to provide or you have to give a certain clarification about what are the various services a particular bank will be dealing into. So as per the list of services or as per the list of functions, you have to specifically tell the SEBI that these are the various services or these are the various functions that we'll be performing, and these activities that will be undertaken by the merchant banker. क्लैरिफिकेशन ऑन एंड पर्सनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन. पर्सनल रिप्रेजेंटेशन देने आपका बिजनेस किस नाम से रजिस्टर्ड होगा, आपके बिजनेस के मेंबर्स कौन होंगे, आपके बिजनेस के पार्टिसिपेंट्स कौन कौन होंगे, वेल वेर what will be your participants of the business, during what stages in or in or in what activities the business activities will be performed, and so on. So all these services you have to give a certain information, and accordingly based on these different types of services or based on the different types of personal information, you have to see that everything has been disclosed and properly been filed with the SEBI that is there into existence. Next thing is the consideration of application. Now, what will the SEBI do? The SEBI will accept this particular application, and based on the application that has been received, they will properly scrutinize about what are the various services, what are the various activities that they have to perform, and in what way the activities can be completed. So, what is the consideration that has been provided? Whether the share capital that has been required is quite optimum? What is the eligibility of the board of directors, of the functions of the managers, lead managers, underwriter, whether it has been feasible or not feasible, and all the compliances with respect to the state government and the central government has been fulfilled or not been fulfilled? So if all these formalities has been completed, then second last situation comes a situation wherein you are being given a certain permission of granting a certificate, wherein the SEBI, that is specifically Securities and Exchange Board of India, gives you a certain certificate, and then you become an official registered merchant banker. Apart from your banking activity, all the activity that have been conducted by a scheduled bank, non-scheduled, cooperative, non-cooperative, public sector, private sector bank are completely different, and the activities of a merchant banker are completely different. So you get a proper certificate from a SEBI wherein you have been classified or you have been certified as a merchant banker. For example, if you treat as a certain bank as an Axis Bank, to Axis Bank ko banking authority ka certificate alag milega aur merchant banking ka certificate alag milega. So you have to take proper two different certificates from the different trade perspectives. Payment of fees and the consequences of failure to pay fees. So whatever the registration fee that has been provided or specifically provided by the SEBI, you have to properly pay the registration fee. Now this particular registration fee you have seen in the earlier slide or the initial beginning, that is, it differs from 10 lakh, 50 lakh, 1 crore, 2 crore, 5 crore, and so on. So, जैसे जैसे आपका टाइप ऑफ बिजनेस है, जो टाइप ऑफ एक्टिविटीज आप करने वाले हो, जो टाइप ऑफ फंक्शंस आप परफॉर्म करने वाले हो, उस हिसाब से आपके डिफरेंट पेमेंट ऑफ फीस एग्जिस्टिंग में होती है. सो एज मेनी नंबर ऑफ सर्विसेज दैट यू आर गिविंग फॉर, सो अमाउंट योर फीस और योर पेमेंट ऑफ फीस डिफर्स. And consequences of failure. So if at any stage or point of view it has been observed or it has been found that they, if you are not paying a certain amount of fee that has been properly as a part of mandate, then the SEBI has a certain right or a certain authority that they may cancel your license also. So aapka license cancel ho sakta hai, and they can take back your grant of certificate. So accordingly the proper registration certificate has to be obtained, and if the fees is not been deposited or not been kept with the SEBI, then your certificate of license may get cancelled. Now, second last slide we are dealing, we'll see, is the qualities of a merchant banker. So, what are the various qualities that a merchant banker has? First thing, or the major quality, is the ability to analyze. So, at every stage or every point of time, the merchant banker has to act as an analyst as a certain perspective. So, agar aapko kahi bhi job opportunity, job offer milta hai, and you have been appointed as a merchant banker, you have to be very specific in analyzing the different situations. So, analyzing a particular situation, that is ups and downs in a particular market, demand and supply forces, positive and negative flow of a particular economy, what is the trend that a particular economy is going for, what is a particular trend in a particular industry, in a particular sector, in a particular market, in a domestic economy, in an international economy, all these factors you have to analyze, and you have to see that what is the condition or what is the situation of a particular economy that is there into existence. Second situation or second quality of a merchant banker is the abundant knowledge. At every stage or every point of time, he must be having a complete and full of knowledge about all the factors and all the intrinsic and extrinsic factors into production. That is, what is the level of production? What is the level of employment? What is the level of feasibility or the demand and supply forces into a particular market? The abundant or the complete information must be made available with a particular merchant banker. Second, third factor or the third quality is the perception of the innovative approach. Innovative approach is the conception of the scenario with respect to the situation of innovative practices. That is, if a particular amount is not being raised from a certain perception, then how the particular amount can be raised from different sources. That is, now in the example that we have taken of raising a certain sum of money from 1000 crore. Now, for example, if State Bank of India, that is SBI, says that we are not going to give 150 crore, but only 50 crore can be raised. So how the remaining amount of 100 crore can be raised from different sources? So you have to apply different innovative approaches. You have to see that what are the various approaches that can be applied, what are the various options that are made available for us, and in what way the services can be rendered to the client that is there in existence. Next, second last is the perception of integrity. Now, integrity is a particular situation or a certain factor wherein you have to identify at every stage or every situation wherein you see that integrity, that is proper coordination between all the members and all the participants, has to be there into consideration, and a proper feasibility on sharing of resources at all the stages or all the situation is needed to be required. And lastly, the capital market familiarity. So capital market familiarity is a particular situation wherein you have to see that what are the various sources of finances that you are looking for, whether you are raising the certain sum of money from either the primary market, secondary market, bond market, equity market, debenture market, stock market, and so on. So capital market similarity, that is all the traders, all the investors has to be there into a certain situation wherein at every stage or every point of time, you have to be in a certain situation. You are quite familiar. Whatever the fund amount that you have to reserve, that you have to require, that you have to raise, it has to be raised in a proper timeline. The proper scenario of whether you are going for an IPO, that is initial public offering, which is a first time issue or a regular issue or a frequent issue or a closure of a particular issue, receipt of a money, closure of a certain money, at every stage or every point of time, all the capital market services are completed in a specific time duration and in a specific time frame or a timeline. Okay. With this situation, it's 12:55. I'll conclude the lecture. So if you have any difficulty or any questions, you can please unmute yourself and ask me the questions. This session will also end automatically. Or you can drop your questions in the chat box. I'll just read it out and answer the questions accordingly. Screen was not visible. Okay, I'm sharing the PPT with you for everyone so that you can go back to the slides also. So everything will be made available. It's around 169 slides, so it's take time to load. Yes, any questions, please ask. Or we'll conclude with the session. Bhargavi, Sejal, Anaga, Mehul, any questions? Deepak, Shivani, Rohit, and who else?
No, sir.
Okay, chalo. Should we conclude? Close?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, everyone, for joining. Good day.